Water technology is the hidden gem of the investment world. Mark my words. Water tech companies are forecasted to multiply their value by nearly 5 in the next decade to reach a $1.4 trillion valuation. Wanna hop on the ride? Well, I reviewed the 1,188 water tech investments that closed over the past 6 years to find out what the overall water tech investment landscape looks like, who are the 5 players that closed the most deals, and the 5 players that cut the largest checks, share you some fun facts to shine at your next water investor dinner, and finally look at some trends and insights.
Shall we start?
Yes.
Great.
So I looked up all the growth investment moves that happened in water tech since the beginning of 2018. That's 415 deals for a total invested money of $3.1 billion. And as I covered in previous videos, the numbers are growing, with the last full year on record, 2023, being the largest ever, with $773 billion deployed that year alone. Now, deals often involve more than one investor, extreme examples of that being Sources Series D in 2022 and Wasted's seed round in 2023, which both boasted 12 different investors on the cap table. On average, there are just a little less than 3 investors per deal, which leads us to the 1,188 actual water tech investments I alluded to just seconds ago. Now, we, the water people...
A lot of weirdos in this neighborhood.
Indeed. Well, we often acknowledge that the water sector is scattered, and it is. So it's no big surprise that the water tech investor landscape actually follows that trend, with no less than 933 different investors that cut a check since 2018. Actually, 775 of them only made one investment. And most of the ones that did more than one actually simply participated in different funding rounds of a single company. The top 5 of investors by the number of deals we'll cover later was actually pretty simple to make. It's all the ones that did 6 deals or more. The bar is pretty low. But how much do these people invest? Well, on average, a growth stage check in water tech is of $2.6 billion. But that average is driven up by some large outliers, as the median check is of $1.45 million, and 367 of the 1,188 investments are under $1 million. A little anecdote to close that first section: the smallest check on my record was cut by the Techstars Sustainability Accelerator when they acquired 6 persons of influence in their seed round in 2021 for $20,000.
That's a bargain.
So, who are these 5 investors that participated in 6 deals or more? Well, Techstars was close to make the cut there, as they did 5 deals, like DCVC, Our Crowd, Almi Invest, and Sustainable Development Technology Canada, but we have 2 tied for 4th: Emerald Technology Ventures and Y Combinator. Let's take the famous San Francisco Startup Accelerator first. As getting selected in their program involves getting a check against 7-person equity, it's no real surprise to see them featured here. Except that since 2018, they cut equity checks to 3,218 companies. So, acknowledging that only 6 checks went to water endeavors is pretty revealing. The world spends 0.2% of its GDP on water. Well, the world leading startup accelerator spends 0.2% of its thoughts on water.
I don't think that's logical decision making.
Well, me neither, but facts are facts. It's actually even beyond that, because Y Combinator actually only invested in 3 companies, with 1 check to Waterplan, 2 to Biobot Analytics, and 3 to Sologen. But hey, they're in the top 5, so let's look at the other 4th tied: Emerald Technology Ventures. Based out of Switzerland, Emerald has a sustainability investment thesis with water and wastewater as one of their 6 verticals. If I had looked even before 2018, they would have probably featured a bit higher, as they were one of the first specialist funds to look into water and did more investments in the early 2010s. Still, over my investigation period, they cut checks to SoFi Filtration, Hydropoint, Indra Water, Binovate, and Sewer AI twice. So let's move to number 3, HG Ventures, with 9 deals. Now, HG could actually also be higher on this list, as the Heritage Group.
What?
That's what it means.
HG, Heritage Group. Anyways, they're also teaming up with Techstars for the acceleration program, which means some or all of the 5 checks cut by Techstars could be somewhat added to HG Ventures' total. Regardless, they've invested in PowerTech Water, Aclarity, and Zwitterco once, and in Pure Affinity, Transcend, and 120 Water twice. Fun fact, aside from PowerTech, they've all been guests on my podcast, And 120 Water will be back for an update very soon. Megan is simply too good to not be there twice. Let's move to number 2 with Pure Terra Ventures and their 12 investments. By the way, the Dutch Water Pure player is actively raising its fund too if you want to hop on the bandwagon. None of this is investment advice, but I was at their LP day a couple of weeks ago and they have a really good grasp of this sector. Anyways, their 12 checks went to Diamidex, Pure Blue, iFlux, Vapar, Membrion, Swan Systems, Siga OT Solutions, Rubix, who changed their names to Elona, Sarah Helix, Twice, and Transcend, Twice as well. Lots of cool people on this list too. Expect to hear some of them on the podcast anytime soon to join Greg in my alumni list. And that leads us to number 1, probably to no one's surprise, Burnt Island Ventures with 26 investments. Now, interestingly, Burnt Island also cut 3 of the 7 smallest checks amongst my 1,188 list. So it's not all about big chunks of money, but about placing your bets right and balancing the risk profile, something I discussed in great length with Tom Ferguson, the founder of Burnt Island Ventures, on the podcast, and I promise I stop with the shameless plugs.
Shame.
Now fasten your seatbelts, because here we go for the 26 checks: Subica, Erie Green, Flood Base, Beagle Services, Civil Grid, Doppler, Spout, Hope Hydration, Liar, 2S Water, Storm Sensor, Zilper Trenchless, Shower Stream, Ziptility Twice, Aclarity Twice, Aquafortress Twice, Zwitterco Twice, Swift Comply Twice, and Sewer AI Thrice.
That's a lot of money.
And actually, Hope Hydration is the first announced investment in Burnt Island's second fund, but they've closed 2 more that aren't public yet. I'm such an insider! Well, I'm reading Tom's blog. But to the real question, when you cut 26 checks, are you one of the 5 largest water tech investors? No. Indeed, the top 5 by amount of capital deployed is pretty surprising, because the 3 players on top only cut 1 large check, and the 2 largest ones actually cut it to the same company at the same time. Meanwhile, Burnt Island and its 26 checks only features in 13th position in this ranking by the money. But let's get that top started with number 5. Insight Partners. Insight is one of the 20 largest private equity firms in the world and has been home to companies like Monday.com or Mural. When it comes to water, they've cut 4 checks to 3 companies in Clear's Series A, no comment, but the link is in the description, in Olia Edge Analytics Series C, and in Wins Series B and C. Now, take my figures with a pinch of salt, because while the total money raised in these kind of rounds is quite always public, the exact split between investors is often not. So I did some guesstimates, and that's how I believe Insight Partners invested a bit more than $53 million on these 4 deals. Number 4 has also made 4 investments, but all to the same company, Source.
Don't say it.
The writing's on the wall.
That investor is no one else than Breakthrough Energy Ventures, created and funded by Bill Gates, with co-investors such as Jeff Bezos, Mark Zuckerberg, or Jack Ma. The fact that Breakthrough invested in Source for about $57 million and in no one else is pretty logic when you think of it. Let me take an analogy. We humans, when we let our imagination conceptualize aliens, we often figure them as little gray humanoids, like they kinda resemble us, but they're very different. Well, if you're a tech mogul like Bill Gates or Jeff Bezos, and you have to imagine, somewhat blindly, an innovative water company that will change the game, you think of something that resembles what you know, and hence you imagine a wireless water/energy nexus play that creates water out of thin air. And that's Source. By the way, I just discovered that Source now bottles its water as well. Do what you want with this info. But let me close that sidetrack and move to number 3. Cowen Sustainable Investments, that poured $70 million in Bevy Series D. And I don't have much to say here, so I'll go straight to the tied number 1s. Bolt Rock Holdings and Centaurus Capital, the 2 funds behind Gradient's $225 million Series D. I don't know if it was a 50-50 or a 2/3, 1/3 type of situation, but in all cases, they would be the 2 largest investors just with that round alone. Meanwhile, the water tech's first ever unicorn recently announced a new PFAS removal offer leveraging foam fractionation, while they're expanding their industrial offering to chemicals, so who knows? There might be a Series E down the line that knocks Bolt Rock and Centaurus out of the leader spot.
There's always a bigger fish.
Now, I have some fun facts for you, starting with this question: do you follow basketball? If you do, even a little bit, you've probably heard of the Golden State Warriors dynasty.
Dynasty?
Hey, I'm French. Tell me in the comments.
Well, the Dynasty won four NBA titles between 2015 and 2022, with Draymond Green as a major actor in those four titles, while also winning two Olympic golds with Team USA and getting selected four times to the All-Star Game. What's the link between that story and water tech? Well, Draymond Green is also a co-investor in LARC's Series A, and LARC even produced a special DG23 edition of its self-purifying water bottles. Talking of star power, I also noted that John Legend is an investor in Roshan, but as I didn't find any actual press or social releases that insisted on that, I'd tend to believe that it's a homonym and not the actual singer.
All of me loves all of you.
What's interesting to note as well in the list of investors that did some waves in water...
You know that's a terrible pun.
I do, but I wanted to highlight how companies like Samsung, Google or Amazon, three times actually for Amazon, do select investments in water endeavors. That speaks to GWI and XPV's white paper that predicted an increased investment of corporates in mitigating their water risk. Interestingly, countries also play their role, with France through its public investment bank, Canada or Israel featuring in the top 20 by the number of deals closed. And talking of geographies, 50% of the growth money is spent in North America, 34% in Europe, 10% in Asia and 6% in the rest of the world. If we split this further down, 42% of the money is invested in the US, 11% in the UK, 8% in Canada, 5% in France, and 4% in Israel and Australia.
Now that was a lot of fun, thank you.
You're welcome. So let's round it off by looking at some trends. First, as hinted to, the overall invested capital in water tech's growth stages is rising. We've seen a give or take 9% compound annual growth rate since 2018, and as we're approaching the middle of 2024, I'd say that we're on track to keep that pace. Of course, if Source or Gradient raises a Series E, that will majorly impact the trends. But if we take out the outliers, what we see is that topics like lithium extraction that barely existed before 2021 rapidly gain momentum, while the water-food nexus that we probably should care about still doesn't move that much forward. Overall, digital endeavors attract 1/4 of the capital, and if anything, it's rather going down than up in market share, even though still a leader, which to me means that digital now hopefully horizontally integrates in all other verticals. In terms of investors, beyond all I already said, I'm surprised to see that large water industry groups don't invest more in growth stage companies like what they did at times when some of them had venture arms. Today, Xylem does its move indirectly, and players like Veolia or Suez rather sporadically shoot for a precise target with respectively one and two deals over the past 6 years. In the end, the corporate that's the most active in growth stage water tech investment is not even a water company, it's SQM, the Chilean lithium giant. Now, if we look on the horizon, the next big milestone would be to see how pure players like Burnt Island Ventures, Pure Terra Ventures, or to a lesser extent, HG Ventures, close their Fund 1 cycles, to whom and for how much they exit from this investment wave. Because that will be the trendsetter. If they prove their investment thesis right, then we might see more pure players in the future or a growing importance for the current generation that would also raise money to keep supporting their portfolio in larger and later funding rounds. That's not so long away in the future, and it's for sure a path I'll continue to review and report on, so if that's of interest to you and you haven't subscribed yet, it will only take you one click on the red button and you're covered. While you're at it, hitting the like button is the nicest reward you can give me. And if investing through venture capital or private equity is not so much your thing, you're more of a public stock market person, then watch this video next to understand what's happening with water stocks. And I'll see you next time.